low, you can still go. Even when you feel slow, you can still go.
Hey everybody, welcome back to the Champions for Christ Christian Church Bookwork. And I'm Dr. Darryl L. Jones, the senior pastor of this amazing church that God has allowed me to pastor some of the greatest people I know. And if you don't have a church home, feel free to be a part of Champions for Christ Christian Church. You can visit us on our website at c4cchurch.com, or you can email us at c4cchurch@gmail.com. I try to come every week or so and bring some words that I feel God has inspired me to want to communicate to those of y'all who will listen to this. Today, I want to talk about no deposit, no return. You know, I know a lot of us don't use banking no more the way we used to. It used to be a time you just have to go to the bank, get a deposit slip, give it to the teller or the bank person, and they'll put money into your account and you could be able to check your balance later, have money in your bank. So when it was time to need it, you could write a check against the money that you deposited, or you could withdraw it. And now we just have everything, Cash App, PayPal, Zelle, transferring in between accounts, ACH. We have so many ways of moving money now, not even talking about digital currencies like the cryptos and things like that. But do you know that if you don't make a deposit, you can't get a return? Because what are you going to draw from if you never put nothing in? Everything we could ever imagine is waiting for us in the spirit realm. I believe that, and that comes from my studying and reading the Word of God. I believe that there's a spirit realm that there's so much available to us through faith that we can receive if we were to exercise our faith and work our faith to receive it. Do you know that the word money simply means a medium of exchange? Money is a currency. But do you also know that faith is a currency as well? We use faith as a currency to transfer God's provision for us from the spiritual realm to the physical realm. What do I mean? Well, we know Hebrews 11 and 1 that says faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. So what that tells me is there's so much that goes on in the spiritual realm that we don't see. But if you use your faith to trust it, and you use your faith to put your hope and all your being in God through it, it will come forth. Because I believe spiritual currency works the same way as physical currency. I believe I'm rich, not that I have millions on millions on millions in the bank account, but I believe I have access to it through God. And when God is ready to give it to me, it's available. And I'm always have this belief. I don't believe I'm poor at all. I don't have to have money in the bank for me to say that I'm not poor. I say I'm not poor because I believe I serve a God who's able to give me the desires of my heart, and know that once God give me that desire, just like God can give you that desire, we can have access to things. You don't necessarily have to have it. Some of y'all have money in the bank right now. But the money is no good until you go and withdraw it. But you couldn't withdraw it if you never put anything into it. And that's what I feel about our spiritual currency. We have to pray. We have to meditate on the Word of God. And we have to talk and communicate with God and trust God with things in the spirit. So when we need it in the physical, God will reveal it to us and give it to us in the physical. Do you know when you have an abundance of money in your physical bank account, you can do a lot of things with it? You can shop, you can pay bills, you can give money, you can donate to charities, you can travel, you can do a lot of things with that money. But do you know that same currency works in the spiritual as well? I truly believe when you have a good spiritual currency, a good amount of deposits into the spiritual currency bank account, do you know you'll be able to heal those who are sick? Do you know you'll be able to feed those who are hungry? You'll be able to clothe those who don't have clothing? See, faith is the substance of things hoped for. It didn't say it was the things hoped for. It said it's the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. So if you're struggling in life, don't have enough money to do the things you desire, don't have enough money to take care of the things that you desire to take care of, check your spiritual bank account. Have you been praying? Have you been seeking God's will? Have you forgiven everybody of everything? Are you loving everybody the way God demanded us to love everybody? Well, those are the things that help get us started. So, no deposit, no return. So, let's start putting a lot of deposits into our spiritual account, and then we'll be able to wire that to our physical account. ACH it to our physical account. Zelle or PayPal or Cash App to our physical account. You get the picture and you get the message. Because we are a spiritual being living in a physical world, and all of these things happen in our life. And let God lead us and let God direct us and watch God do what God do best, which is make ways out of no ways, make possibilities out of impossibilities, and make your life be better on purpose. Well, thank you so much for tuning in to Champions for Christ Christian Church Book Work. If we work the book will work. I want to charge you and I want to implore you to start studying the Word of God. Start following us at Champions for Christ Church. Again, c4cchurch.com, or you can email us at c4cchurch@gmail.com. You can follow us every Sunday during our worship experience on Facebook Live at 10 o'clock a.m. Or you can follow us on our Zoom, on our website, or any other social media platforms that you're following me on. Well, until we're together again, peace, because we are champions for Christ. Hustle every single day.